here's my submission. So what we had to do is I built up a list called submissions that's going to hold the links that are submitted by this author. So the first thing I do is I iterate over the list links for L and links. And if the submitter ID matches our constraint, 62443, I add it to our list of submissions here. And then I said sorted by time ascending. So then I need to call sort on this list here. And if you haven't used the sort function, it's pretty handy. So you can just call sort, and that'll sort by whatever the Python default would be. So if it's integers, it sorts by integers. But these aren't integers. These are, you know, entire link objects. So Python would probably sort it lexicographically based on how it prints out, I think. So we want to sort on submitted time, so that's what the key parameter is for. And then I return the submissions. And so if I run my query, you can see the output down here. And you can see we have three links. It's not the easiest thing to read. Here's link number one, and submission time is 133390. And we can see our next link is here. And we can see the submission time is 133393, so bigger, good. And finally down here, we can see our last link, and its submission time is 1334. Okay, so they're sorted by submission time, and we can see they all have submitter ID 62443 here and here. Okay, so that was not too hard, but it was still a little tedious. And this is the type of thing these types of problems a database can help with.